You know, it sounds crazy to call the second game of the year a must-win. After all, Wofford's only 0-1, Samford 0-2. But why does it feel that way? Here's why. Home opener, conference opener, and if you're going to make a run at a third straight Southern Conference championship and get one of these in the process, it all has to start tonight.
And it's got to happen for 60 minutes. You understand me?
Yes, sir.
Not one quarter, not two quarters. 60 minutes. You understand that?
Yes, sir.
Okay. You take the field tonight, between those white lines, all right, you got to be a different guy. You got to. You ain't sending class anymore, all right? You're not downtown. You understand that?
Yes, sir.
Be physical at the point of attack. Control the line of scrimmage. And let's go get this W.
Now at their own 45, shotgun snap, Oladokun will pass. He's got a scramble to his left. All his receivers were covered, and now he'll flip it inside, and it's picked off by Allstat. Goes down at the 35-yard line of Wofford, and the Terriers get the turnover on the very first possession. Second and a three from the 42-yard line. They give us up the middle. Blake Morgan breaks a tackle. He's got first down yardage out across the 45 to the 47, and a fresh set of downs for Wofford. One in motion is Luther. He'll take the jet sweep, turn the corners, got the first down across the 40 to the 35 to the 34 before being driven back, and a fourth down conversion, the first fourth down conversion of the year for Wofford. Staten on the tackle. Joe gets the snap. It'll be a fake option, and Joe goes up the middle. He's got the first down, 20, 15, knocked down at the 15, and Wofford will move the chains again after a 13-yard scamper by Joe Newman. Walker to the left of Newman in the shotgun. Walker has it, scampers into the end zone, unmolested for the Terrier touchdown. Nathan Walker from 1 yard out. Quick snap, tempo, going back to throw. Now Oladokun rolls to his right. He can run with the ball. He'll do that. He's got the first down across midfield into Wofford territory. Across the 40, a trip down at about the 37-yard line. That is going to be an 18-yard scramble. Oladokun in the shotgun. He goes back to pass, looking left. Nobody there. Great coverage. He's got a circle back. He's still scrambling. Gets away from another man. He's way back at midfield and still running for his life. Finally, makes one man miss, and he'll have the first down down the right sideline. What a job by Chris Oladokun. Oladokun still back in the shotgun. They still got Dorsted in the backfield. And he looks, throws right. End zone, a back shoulder fade, and it's complete. A 12-yard touchdown strike for Samford. Robert Adams with his second touchdown of the year. First and 10 Wofford from their own 15. It's Newman handing off. Jet sweep to Van Cleve, and he's got yardage across the 25, all the way out to the 29-yard line. Quick gain of 14 yards for Demorier Van Cleve, player on the stop for Samford. First and 10 Terriers from their own 41. Newman's back to pass. Now he'll roll to his right. Look long, and it's complete. Across midfield to the 47 is Van Cleve. That'll be a gain of 12, and a good-looking throw from Joe Newman right into the midst of Demorier Van Cleve. He's crouched plenty of time on the play clock, and Newman on the option will keep it around right side. He's got room, 40, 35, out near the Samford 30-yard line. Joe Newman doing what he does best with his legs. Three on the clock. Walker takes the handoff. Touchdown, Terriers! Nathan Walker, his second of the game, and it's 13-7 Wofford. From the Samford 30, handoff up the middle, a good run up the middle, and that's Pete Dorsten. Oladokun back to throw, looking left. Slant complete to the 10, inside the 10 to the 7, gain of 17 yards for Jairus Kramer. First and goal, Bulldogs. More of a traditional formation. It'll be a handoff and up the middle and down close to the goal line. And scoring, in fact, is Stanton, Jay Stanton. No huddle. Second down and 9. Oladokun nailed as he throws the ball. That was nearly a safety. And Ryan Titus got in there and blasted the Samford quarterback. Oladokun rolls left, throws right, throws left. It's complete. Short gain out across the 10, breaking the tackle. And off to the races. 30. 40, and all the way out to midfield. That's a huge, huge gainer for Samford. And Broussard as Joe rolls right on the option and keeps it. He's got the 30. First down and more for Joe Newman. 15-yard scamper out to the right, all the way out to the 40-yard line, and that's the way you start off half number two for the Terriers. Center power eye formation, and Joe will option left. He'll keep it again. He's got positive yardage and another close to a first down as Newman slides across the 50-yard line. And Oladokun, the little quarterback keeper, has got a first down. 25-20, breaks a tackle. 10-5, Chris Oladokun, touchdown, Samford. 30 yards right up the middle. So we got a strong formation to the left. Morgan will run that way, and he's got blockers. Gets to the 45, back to the left. Handoff. Morgan makes a man miss across the 40. First down, tough run, Blake Morgan, and the chains move all the way down to the Samford 38. Second down, sweep right. Hurdling a player is Blake Morgan down close to first down yardage. He'll be about a yard short across the 30 to the 29. Wofford, ball on the 15 of Samford, 5:22 and counting as Morgan sweeps left. Hurdles a man. He's got the sideline shoved out of bounds after a gain of about five. The play was good. They hadn't run that play, but Lamar Anderson never bit on the ball fake, and he was with Nick Karras every step of the way, and Samford takes over on downs with 3:14 to play. The Bulldogs line up in that victory formation. Remember, they will go to 1-2. Wofford will drop to 0-2, and more importantly, 0-1 in the Southern Conference. From our vantage point upstairs, which doesn't always jive with yours down on the field, seems like there was a lot to like out there. Just hard to put away drives, and obviously the final score. Not sure what you were looking for.
Yeah, no, I mean, I felt like we came out offensively and played a whole lot better. I mean, I was really impressed with the way that Joe played on offense. You know, we just got to figure out a way to finish those drives, especially in the second half. I mean, we ran the ball through the red zone, which was encouraging to see in that first half. But the second half, just, you know, we couldn't finish those drives, exactly what you said. And then defensively, we finally started getting some stops in the second half. But, you know, they were a higher-powered offense. I mean, we knew that coming in. So what's discouraging is you keep the ball away from them. You control the clock. You run the football. Everything we wanted to do, but just didn't score enough points.
You held that offense to 7 second-half points. Unfortunately, they turned out to be the only points anybody scored in the second half. With everything that you just mentioned, a lot of things to build off positively?
Oh, yeah. And like I told the guys, I mean, it's a long season, right? I mean, they've got a long – it's the first conference game. We got a long way to go. But we know that. We understand that. And we'll come back and, you know, we got the web coming up. And we'll get better this week. And we want to play our best football in October and November. And that's always going to be the message. And I still think we got the opportunity to do that, especially if we make the improvements that we made going from the first game to this game. We got back to playing our style of football, and we'll get better on defense especially.
Boy, you'd like to think that when you hold Samford to 7 second-half points, when you take the ball away from them twice, that good things are going to happen. And the defense did play a whale of a ball game. But things just aren't clicking right now for the Terriers. They are 0 for Bulldogs after losing to South Carolina State and Samford. Next up, another set of Bulldogs come to town. It'll be Gardner-Webb next Saturday. For Inside Wofford Football, I'm Jim Noble.